Hi everyone, I am Tenny. So thanks for joining this call. I've come up with some funds. So this can be taken. This is not a buying recommendation. You can all go and check and study. This is just an easy way I'm just telling. So this is a benchmark. You can go and see like whether there are any other funds which is better than whatever I'm going to suggest, and you can buy them. So what I have seen is that of late Axis fund house, in my last 25 to 28 years dealing with the mutual funds and equity, I have funded for the first time. Fund house has completely outperformed in all the schemes. There are different schemes like large cap, mid cap, small cap, thematic funds, multi cap, ELSS. In all this one, they are mostly, most of them, they are in number rank one, very few cases rank two. So that itself gives a case for considering these funds. And their performance for last 1 year is, I mean, excellent. They have done it consistently over a few months, but then if you just see the last 2 months performance, this may not be leading the, I mean, there are some funds which has given more returns. So one thing is that see all these mutual funds, I mean, this is a generic thing. Most of the mutual funds after the market fall in the last 3 months, small caps and mid caps have all given 32% returns. So it's not that only if you go and buy your stocks, you can make a return. See, so have that faith in him and then just go and invest in N100 ETF. That if you want a global fund exposure, this is a very good way of, this is an ETF. This is Motilal Oswal NASDAQ 100 ETF, exchange traded fund, whereby you can get an exposure to all the NASDAQ tech companies. I'll show you which are the companies that it holds. And nowadays, pharma is doing well, not just because of COVID, but then otherwise also pharma was just coming out of the woods after a 10-year fall. So thematic fund, it's a thematic fund, the last one. The thematic funds are actually, whatever the thing, it's a bit risky. You need to be very careful about this one because I am thinking that thematic funds will, I mean, pharma fund will do well. But if reverse happens, the losses also will be very, very high. Before we continue, if you find this video interesting, and if you want your friends also to watch this, please like it, share my video with your friends and press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. So, but then I feel that over the next few years, the pharma funds will do well. So I have formulated one model portfolio with mutual funds, which if anyone wants, and this is a very generic one, depending on your risk taking ability and everything, you can make changes in this one, or you can completely avoid this and put something new into that also. So the first two funds, Axis Focus 25, Axis Multicap. A multicap fund will be having all the caps like large cap, small cap, mid cap. But I they have a large cap fund, Axis Blue Chip. But I just avoided that and put these two over there because I found that these two have better underlying securities. So I just put, I have just put 35% into large cap itself. Axis Focus is focusing on 25 companies which can do well over the next few years. Multicap also, right now they are more 35% into large caps. So the first two are the large caps things, then it's a mid cap fund and a small cap fund. A mid cap and small caps, no, I mean, it is risky, but the returns can be huge. You can't expect L&T to double its business in 2 years. But whereas a small cap company, which is, if it is in the right business, right idea, it can triple or go 5 times in the matter of 2-3 years. So that is why that is there. Then the ELSS fund also, you have the Axis long-term equity, which has a lock-in period of 3 years. So now let's see like, yeah. So I'm just going to Money Control where I just use this platform for analyzing the thing. So I'll quickly go to, you can just go to Axis Midcap. You can search for any funds over here. So select mutual funds. So as I said, you should go for direct plan only, direct growth. Okay, you shouldn't go for anything else. So Axis Midcap direct growth plan. So you can see the CRISIL rating over here, 5 stars. This is the maximum stars. And you can see the NAV over here. You don't have to worry about the NAV. You shouldn't, whether it is 42 or 4,200, I don't mind. I am only worried about other things. So the fund size, 5,156 crore, it's having, its expense ratio is as low as 0.56. So for 1 lakh, you need to pay only 560 rupees a year. And as you come down, you can just look at the portfolio. So this is how you can also do your analysis. That's why I just sort of showing this. Okay, so you can see like where they are investing. There. Good. 5% is into Avenue Supermarts, then Ipca Labs, Bata India, so all those things. So this Axis Midcap Fund is doubling as a consumption fund. I like consumption. I have been recommending some other consumption fund earlier, but then I found that okay, this is the midcap fund, and then they have the consumption also. So this is the thing. So this is the fund here. You can select the sector over here, so you can see according to sectors what all they are having. See the pharmaceuticals, things are there. Then Avenue Supermart, Trent, Aditya Birla Fashion, all those things. Banks, City Union Bank. Since it's a mid-cap fund, doesn't have much bigger banks, only HDFC, ICICI is there. Then you have Cholamandalam Finance, which is the consumer finance companies. Bajaj Finance, Cholamandalam Finance. You have the computer hardware. You have Indraprastha Gas. So you have Bata, Voltas for your AC, cement companies. So everything is mostly a consumption fund. Tata Consumer Products, Whirlpool for your washing machines, all those stuff. Okay. Okay, now you just see the peers and see like what is this one. So here you can see, you can compare like what are the other funds over there. You can see in this line, see your Axis Midcap Fund 5-star, and you have one more 5-star thing is there. So you can see the 1 year return over here. Axis has given a 8% return. Last 2 years has been a very catastrophic year for midcaps. So in spite of that, it has given an 8% return. See the other funds which are in the similar thing. They are not even got 50%. That means they have outperformed 100% in the thing. You also need to see the 3 year, 5 year thing. So this is one criteria of searching like how good is your fund. Okay, so here you can, this way you can see. Similarly, you can go to ELSS funds and see who is doing good over there. You have Axis with the 5-star over there too. See, very few funds are having 5 stars. All others are 3-star, 4 stars. So, and see their AUM size, 20,000. And see the 1 year performance. It's minus 0.3. But then I didn't consider BOI, AXA because, I mean, they were not very consistent in other things like expense ratio, all those things. I mean, all those things considering Axis excels there too. So, likewise, large cap also you can check. So, likewise, you can check for all these funds and you can find out like which is doing good. Okay. Now let's see Nasdaq, Motilal Oswal, Nasdaq 100 ETF. This is what I was telling. So this is an ETF. You can buy directly from the shares from exchange only. Benchmark index is Nifty. They have kept, actually, it should have been Nasdaq. But then see the output. You should look at this outperformance also. In certain cases, the outperformance won't be there. That itself shows that the fund is not performing well. So this, if you go and check their portfolio, of course, this is a bit risky thing. All the Nasdaq stocks have gone up so much over the last few months. But then if you want an exposure, global exposure, you have S&P index also that way. But I would suggest better to go with the tech fund like this. See Microsoft, Apple, Amazon, Facebook, Google, Intel, everything is there. Cisco, Adobe. See, Microsoft is 11%, Apple is 11%. So it's so easy these days, no? You don't have to worry about opening a foreign trading account or converting into USD. So this will be a good hedge for your dollar appreciation also. So if you buy this fund and keep, and then let's say in 2 years, dollar becomes 100. So you'll be getting an automatic surge on that context too. So this is the thing. So I have just explained the things. Okay. So that's the thing. So I want to tell one thing. This is not a, I'm not trying to sell anything over here. I'm not marketing anything. This is just for information and study purpose. You can always go compare and talk to your financial advisor and see. And these days you need to be a bit careful also when you talk to the financial advisor, if he's attached to some institution, some in. So you take your own this one. So many people have asked why I am taking these sessions. So the answer is that I was just talking to one of the friend who is also attending, Krishna, who is attending this one. So we all have been investing for last 20, 30 years. So we have done a lot of mistakes. We have gone through all these things. So some things, if we had known at that point of time, if we had done that one that time, I mean, we would have, the enormous returns would have been made. So this kind of things, I just want to let you know, whoever is just entering newly into a job or career, so they can just do this kind of investments. Please press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.